Howdy folks, Sean here. Figured I'd just shoot a really quick video. In case you don't know what I do, I work in the wireless industry. I have for about 15 years now. Currently, I'm installing 5G in Atlanta, Georgia for Verizon. It's their kickoff market. 5G is, new big thing. Everybody's worried about it. This is a 5G radio. It's made by Ericsson. I'm not showing it too much because I'm sure Verizon doesn't want me showing all their stuff. There is one thing I'll show you right here, though, if we'll focus on it. This is for the power that comes in. I'm hooking it up right now. Focus, you fork. 5.3 amps, 50, 60 hertz. This is the power cable I make up. It's European color code because it's Ericsson equipment and we get the power cable from them. Hey, got me a message. Anyhow, 5.3 amps is what this thing draws. Right here on the bottom, this is a fan unit that cools this because it's a radio. It makes heat, and it's outdoors, so it makes heat in the summertime. The majority of that power that it's drawing up there is the power to run the cooling unit and the fan. This radio, and this is actually the antenna portion of it right here. And this is the radio portion, and this is the interface where fiber and GPS modules go. The majority of the power is used for cooling it. It puts out such a little amount of power. We're hooking it up to a 10-amp circuit breaker down below. Everybody's worried about, ooh, directed energy beam, death ray weapons. We've actually had some people come up to us, ask us what we're doing, find out that it's 5G, and start flipping their lid because 5G death conspiracies and COVID and everything, whatever. This is 5G. It is such a low power that's coming out of this thing. It literally will make it up this corner. That billboard over there would not be getting a signal from this radio. And this one pointing down the street here isn't going to go much past that concrete plant right there. It's such a small footprint for these things. They're such a low power device. It's no more power, honestly. It's a little more power than your home's Wi-Fi router, but not very much. Anyhow, that's it. I just wanted to give my little input on 5G because it's the current hot topic. It's the thing. It's 5G, and there's a lot of people saying stuff, but I think I'm in a unique position. Clearly, I'm in a unique position. 33 foot above the ground. That's a kind of a unique position, isn't it? But clearly, I'm in a unique position to speak on 5G because I'm installing it. Guys, you want to know the truth? I'll tell you the truth about this. It's for self-driving cars, and that's the real whole push for it. This is the only technology that has the low latency communication and throughput for self-driving cars to be able to communicate with each other at a data rate quick enough to be traveling down the street at 45 miles an hour and be able to say, hey, where are you? This is where I am. And to be able to communicate with the bandwidth that's necessary to make self-driving cars a possible thing. That's really the whole push. One of the major pushes for this. Our azimuths, the antennas that we're putting up, they're always straight up and down the street. For a three-way intersection, there's three antennas covering the streets. It's very clear what they're doing. Guys, don't worry about this stuff. It's nothing new. It's not a new frequency, and it's frequencies that have been used forever. It's just been reallocated, and we're using it now for super high bandwidth wireless communication. But it's so low power, guys. You saw right there, this is the radio, 5.3 amps, and the majority of that, again, is for the cooling module in this thing, the fan unit at the bottom. It's got four high power, high airflow fans. This thing makes a heck of a noise when we power it up. You can hear the fans whirring. When I power it up from the ground, I know if they powered up here because I can hear the fans from down there. Maybe not with Marta behind me. Maybe not with Marta behind me when it's going around, but for the most part, yeah, we can hear the fans. Anyhow, that's my input on 5G. Let me finish wiring this up. I'm doing grounding, terminating the powers. Snap a few more pictures. It's Friday, and then got two more sites to go to. Take some closeout photos, and we are heading to the house. That's it for now. KJ4, PTD, 73.